Hello friends. So we are ready with the next question. Question number 22. We have to solve x by 3 plus 3 by 6 minus x is equal to 2 into 6 plus x upon 15. Children, they have given here x is not equal to 6. See, you should know why they have mentioned that x is not equal to 6 over here. Very simple, children. This doesn't it doesn't have much importance in solving the sum, but it is just for information that I am telling you why this x not equal to 6 is mentioned. Children, if suppose the x value is equal to 6, then you know what will happen. Here, if you replace this x with 6, this whole expression will become 6 minus 6, which is equal to 0. And children, you know that you can never have a 0 in the denominator, because any number divided by 0 is what? It is infinite, or it is undefined. That expression is actually what? Undefined. So that is the reason they have mentioned in particular that the x value can never be equal to 6. You can take any other value for x, any real number other than 6. And this is the technical reason behind it. Okay? So that part is clear. Now let us get into the solving part. Okay. Now children, on the left hand side, you are having two denominators. One is 3 and the other one is 6 minus x. What is the LCM of 3 and 6 minus x? The LCM is 3 into 6 minus x. The product of both the denominators will become the LCM. So it is 3 into 6 minus x. Now let us solve the usual way. 3 into 6 minus x upon 3. 3 and 3 get cancelled. What is left? 6 minus x is left. That 6 minus x will get multiplied with x. Done? Now, take the LCM divided with the second denominator. So, 6 minus x and 6 minus x get eliminated. 3 is left, which will get multiplied with the numerator 3. So, this 3 and this 3, they both get multiplied and form 9. Clear? Which is equal to 2 times 6 plus x divided by 15. Children, for the time being, let this 2 into 6 plus x remain like that. Okay, don't change it. We will expand it later on. Now, here we have x into 6 minus x plus 9. Shall we simplify this numerator? Yes. So, x into 6 minus x will become 6x minus x square plus 9. Whole divided by 3 into 6 minus x, which is equal to 2 into 6 plus x divided by 15. Now children, this is forming a by b is equal to c by d format. Yes. So in that case, what we do? We just cross multiply both the sides. So let us cross multiply both the sides. So here 15 will get multiplied with 6x minus x square plus 9, which is equal to, here we have 2 into 6 plus x, and here we have 3 into 6 minus x into 3 into 6 minus x. Correct? Now children, what we can do? We can just open this bracket on the left hand side. Yes. So, children, before even I open this bracket, there is one simple way of simplifying it. Now what is that simple way? Children, we have 3 over here and we have 15 over here. Can I just cancel 3 and 15 directly so that we don't have to multiply each and every term inside this bracket with 15? Isn't it? You have to just multiply it with what? A smaller number than 15, which is 5. Easy? Basic math, children. So 5 into 6x is what? 30x. 5 into x square is what? 5x square. Don't forget to put this minus sign, children. Plus into minus is minus. Then 5 into 9 is what? 45. Which is equal to, now children, 3 is already cancelled, okay? Now here, 2 is there. Now children, what is 6 plus x into 6 minus x? This is of the form a plus b into a minus b, which is a square minus b square. Yes. So children, 6 plus x into 6 minus x will become 6 square, which is 36, and x into x, which is x square. So it is 36 minus x square. Now, children, sorry. 30x minus 5x square plus 45 is equal to, what is 2 into 36? 72. What is 2 into x square? 2x square. So whatever brackets we had till now, we have removed it. Now what we can do? We can shift the location of the LHS or the RHS. I think we can bring this RHS to the LHS. That would be easier. Yes. So children, 30x minus 5x square. When I bring this minus 2x square to the left side, it becomes plus 2x square. Yes. And children, when I bring the 72 to the left hand side, it becomes minus 72, which is equal to 0. I have relocated the entire RHS family to the LHS family, isn't it? Now, 30x, what is minus 5x square plus 2x square? Minus 3x square. And what is 45 minus 72? Minus 27. Is that correct, children? 60, 65, 72. Sorry. Which is equal to what? 0. Children, are we getting a quadratic equation? Yes, we are getting a quadratic equation, but just that, you know, it is not in a proper order. Because in a quadratic equation, we always place the term having x square first, isn't it? So let us do that also. Here I'll get minus 3x square plus 30x minus 27, which is equal to 0. Now I can say that it is a proper quadratic equation, isn't it? Now children, before I start solving it, 3, 30, 27. Can we take a common factor out of all these three numbers? Yes. What is a common factor? 3 is the common factor. Let us take it out. Shall I take minus 3 out? I would rather take minus 3 out. Okay. So children, here what is left? X square. From 30x, if I take minus 3 out, what is left here? Minus 10x. Because minus 3 into minus 10x will give you plus 30x. Okay. Please be very careful regarding these positive and negative signs, children. Otherwise, the entire solution will go wrong. Okay. Now, from minus 27, if I take minus 3 common, what is left here? Plus 9. Why? Because if I open this bracket, it should be minus 3 into plus 9, which is minus 27. Okay. So, for that reason, I have put plus sign over here, which is equal to 0. Children, if I bring this minus 3 to the right hand side, it will become what? 0 divided by minus 3, which is equal to 0 again, isn't it? So what I can do is, I can directly write it as x square minus 10x plus 9, which is equal to 0. Such a decent quadratic equation you are getting. From where we started, children, such a lengthy one, and finally we have reached at x square minus 10x plus 9 is equal to 0. Now, we have to make use of the middle term split method. Can we do it directly, children? The middle term split, x square minus 10x plus 9, can we write it as x square minus 9x minus x plus 9 is equal to 0? Can I just divide minus 10x as minus 9x minus x? Yes, because minus 9x minus x is what? Minus 10x. Children, there is no need of, you know, showing the entire step of A into C, then taking B as the middle value, splitting it into two parts. There is no compulsion like that. Just that, you know, the numbers, when the numbers are big in size, you use the proper method. Otherwise, even if you can do mental calculation, you can solve these sums by using your mind calculations. Okay, there is no compulsion that you have to show that method. So here, let us group it, x square minus 9x, which is x into x minus 9, and here minus of x minus 9, which is equal to 0. This is correct. From x square minus 9x, I have taken x common. So inside the bracket, I will have x minus 9. From minus of x plus 9, I have taken minus 1 common. So inside the bracket, I will have x minus 9. Cross check it. When you open this bracket, it should be minus of x, yes, and minus of minus 9, which is plus 9. So it is correct. Now children, in these two terms, x minus 9 is common. So you get x minus 9 into what? Here what is left? X. Here what is left? Minus 1 is left, which is equal to 0. So this implies x minus 9 is 0 or x minus 1 is 0. Therefore, x is equal to 9 or x is equal to what? 1. Hence, the solution of this given equation is what? Either 9 or 1. Easy? So children, just practice this sum once again in your rough notebook without looking in the video tutorial. Okay? I want you guys to practice these sums on your own, children, after listening to this. Okay, then only, you know, you can become thorough and concrete with all your ideas and concepts. Okay, so see you later. Bye.